What if I ask you to multiply two long primes with d digits each? Well, that's simple. You can just use the algorithm that you know from school, that takes roughly d squared steps, and you're done. Okay, now consider the opposite problem, where I give you a product of two primes, and I ask you to find the prime factors. How would you solve that one? Well, an easy way to do it is just to check whether the number is divisible by 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on until you hit a factor. But this is really slow. If the number I give you has d digits, then its size is up to 10 to the power of d, and therefore you'll need square root of 10 to the power of d steps to find the two factors. And although there are smarter and faster factoring algorithms out there, all of them are still a lot slower than d squared. For example, it was only a few years back when a team of researchers managed to factor this number with 250 digits. And this took them thousands of CPU years. Yeah, CPU years. But why should we care about factoring? Well, if they could factor 10 times longer numbers, that would already threaten the present implementations of the famous RSA cryptosystem that large parts of the internet rely on. And so, ladies and gentlemen, it is with utmost pride that today we, the Polylog team, present to you a simple algorithm for factoring numbers based on Leonid Levin's design, for which we can also prove that the time complexity is asymptotically optimal. That means that whenever you come up with some amazing factoring algorithm, I can prove that our algorithm is either faster than yours or, if it's slower, then only by a constant factor. For example, perhaps our algorithm is twice as slow as yours, but it's at most twice as slow for all inputs, even very large ones. Put differently, you can't come up with an algorithm such that our algorithm would get slower and slower relative to yours as the input size increases. So, our algorithm is simply the best possible, up to constant factors. I won't tell you how it works quite yet. I'll explain that in a follow-up video that we're gonna release in the next few days. Until then, I encourage you to have a look at the algorithm and try to figure out how it works. You can even run it on some real data. The code is available in the video description. If you do, please note that our implementation is in Python, so it's a little bit slow. And with that, good luck and see you in a few days in the follow-up video. Bye-bye!